Dad, tell me what you remember about the Kramer and Sons shop when you were a kid.
I remember that Dad waking me up at 4:30 in the morning and saying, it's time to go to work. And then I worked so hard that by the time I got there and I worked an hour, I had to lie down and take a nap. So he made a little bed for me.
Anything else, Pop-Pop, you want to add about the market?
The Kramer brothers had this entrepreneurial spirit to them, but I'm not sure I really understand like where that came from.
I think it all derived from my father. At the age of 15, he left Russia.
But it was a difficult journey because it was crossing borders without any papers until he got to Bremen in Germany, and he got a ship.
Came to the United States in New York. He went from New York, he went to Baltimore. He didn't like Baltimore. He went further to Washington, and therefore he settled in Washington. If he hadn't settled in Washington, you wouldn't be here.
Market. Go slow, Sam, so he can...
Well, he can walk around with a camera, don't worry about
it. See?
My father got a horse and wagon, and he sold their vegetables from the horse and wagon.
And I used to be so excited by the thought that my dad had a horse. And I'd say, what was the name of the horse? You know, I'm thinking Trigger, or I'm thinking Silver, or something exciting. And the name of his horse was Ferd, which in Yiddish means horse. But from that, he worked himself up into the market. So the market was really a progression. And yeah, I think many families came up that same way.
Deli that Dad went to all the time right here?
Right here, that's where we get breakfast.
When we got to a certain age, we had to go down to the market to go to work. I mean, that was a given.
The boys as such, as they grew older, became an integral part of the operation at the market, especially on Saturday, early in the morning when Dad would wake me, 3 o'clock in the morning, he would say, Herschel.
Mezainen Shen Spet, which means we're now late already, regardless of what time he woke us up.
I just got home from a date.
Of course, you look forward to it because it was a sign of past, you know, past, you were getting into manhood. I think I was 8 years old when I started in the market.
It's all filled up. See, those two buildings right here.
515, and what's the other address?
Next door.
513.
The greatest thrill for me at the very early start was going into the coffee shop and sitting down with all the men from the market, and they spoke all kinds of languages, and sitting on a stool and getting a donut and a cup of coffee. I was one of the guys at that point.
Occasionally, my dad would take me for breakfast to a restaurant down the street at the market. And I always felt very proud to come in, and they recognized my dad, and eventually they recognized me. The name Kramer and Sons, I took very literally, that was me.
Welcome to Kramer and Sons.
Can I help you guys?
My father rents the building to Steve.
Oh.
So he just wants, I want my son to see the inside of the building.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
When we first came down,
to the market in 1932, this was open from here, and we had a sliding door that came down here. And people used to walk along, and we displayed eggs here. And I sold eggs when I was 10 years old.
I'd take a paper bag and make a hat out of it, and that was my official dress. And I'd go out there and I'd spend the entire day selling mayonnaise, salad dressing, and eggs.
People would come by, how much was it? And I knew the price. I think it was 25 cents for a jar, big jar of mayonnaise. And I had the bags there and everything and the apron. And I quailed when I made a sale and I ran in and I made sure my father saw it, you know. And he would, you know, give me the good eye that I did good.
We would cut meat and make roasts and do things along that line.
And we took a strip of bacon, put it on a slicing machine.
And it's sand right here. On the other side, from there to the door, was a fruit stand.
I remember that the Italians who had the fruit stands always offered us bananas or apples or whatever as we walked by. The market was manned by the Italians, the Greeks, and the Jews, and we all became fast friends.
In the next block, there was a business run by a family named Deckelbaum, and they had a son my age, and he and I became friendly.
That was part of the learning process, because you learned how to get along with different people with different backgrounds.
And we would work all day long. Then about 10 o'clock at night, we would start to clean up. And then we would cut kosher meat for the house. Providing for a family during the Depression years was something that was almost a 24-hour day job. And I don't think I ever heard Dad complain about providing for the family. Holidays, Rosh Hashanah, Pesach, we always got new shoes and a new suit, a new shirt.
He knew he had a provider. He had this family, and he had to provide for them. And whatever it took.
I don't really know whether Dad anticipated that all of us would stay in the market, but he did want to keep Kramer and Sons in the family. When Sam came out of the service, he came in and he said, Sid, I don't think there's enough revenue generated in the market to support all three of us. And I told Sam that I'd be glad to leave the market if he was willing to come in.
Yeah, I saw your old scale.
You like that?
Yeah.
I'll give it to you.
What do you feel like you learned the most from your experience working there?
Maintaining my ambition there to do what's right. Their customer came in, wanted to buy something. I was willing to service him as much as I possibly could.
There's never been a county executive other than Sidney Kramer who didn't have a college degree, but I had my degree from my parents and from the market, because I learned as much about how to interact with people, how to respond to challenges in the market as anyone could possibly learn in a college environment.
You take the market, you take the car wash, you take anything that you want. You've got to work at it to be successful, and thank God we were. But it was something that we learned from him, watching Dad. And Dad would preach it too, you know, if there was a work, do it. Just don't stand there with your hands in your pockets, do it. It's something that I tried to educate my boys on, and I think I did a good job too. They all have learned a lot, but it all goes back to my father.
I think one of the things that my father instilled in all of the boys was work ethics, supporting the family. And in fact, it was probably overkill, if anything, that I think most of the boys really worked very, very hard in their businesses to support their family. And I think that was one of the big things that family imparted to us when we started their family.
Dad loved his children and his grandchildren. Dad was never happier than when he had one of the children in his lap and could kiss them and hug them. I found that I was very comfortable with my children, my grandchildren, and hopefully my great-grandchildren.
I'd like to welcome everybody to our Seder.
Their voices have risen in Jewish pride.
The more we tell it in great detail, the more we are to be praised.
What is this all about?
Help us celebrate future holidays and festivals.
It commands us to eat matzah.